has shown that high school football players sustain 650 to 1,000 blows to the head at various levels in a season, and that functional MRI imaging shows a change in altered brain function from beginning to end that can take months to resolve, even in students who weren't diagnosed with a concussion. What evidence is there that the head-first program and technique will result in a reduced number of repetitive head trauma that's significant?
Yeah. Actually, Tom, that is the question that we need to look at. And again, that goes back to that exposure question. And one of the things that we currently have in front of USA Football that we had hoped would get off the ground last year, but because of timing, is to outfit helmets with sensors, or at least heads with sensors, and begin to measure demonstrably changes in exposure, both the numbers of hits and then the levels of hits. So the general view, and I'm involved with the whole hit count kind of process here, is how do we look at those numbers? Basically, the information that we have right now is the unchecked world of football and the numbers of hits that we take. By both reducing exposure in terms of the numbers of contact practices, and then also building better technique into this, then what we do is we reduce that exposure. And that's where the science is going to come in to look at, hopefully then, a reduction in terms of risk of injury. And that's what we need to do now. And again, this is now the merging of technologies, where there are now a variety of sensor systems that can measure in a very continuous way the kinds of hits and the exposure over a season. And what we're hoping is that, or what we believe would at least be our scientific hypothesis, is that by taking a mechanism and a method of heads-up tackling and taking the head out of it, you're going to reduce magnitude and hopefully the numbers then of hits that the head takes as well. And then demonstrating that relative to the standard old method, if you will, or let me just say the current method, it's not really the old method, would then reduce risk. And again, use that to refine it as we go along. I don't think this is the final answer yet, but I do think that as we begin to learn more and more about it and look at, you know, how different body types and other things factor into this, how different positions factor into this, we'll have a better sense of this.
All right, we'll take two more questions. Yes.
Regarding the training program and the certification process, what kind of commitment is that to coaches? How does that training program go? Like, what exactly is it?
Well, the time commitment would be a time commitment for the player safety coach. I think they talk about an eight-hour session. So you're talking about a day, all right, for that coach to be trained, and then that coach would come back and train the staff. We don't think it would be 8 hours with the staff. We think. And then there's an online certification process too. So, when we talked to the coaches about this and so forth, we said, hey, you know, this isn't lip service. You know, you're going to have to commit some time to it. We'll pay for it, you know, but you're going to have to commit some time to it. And so they realized that. Yes?
Just really quickly, what school systems have said, like, they're 100%?
I have a list, and I don't have it right with me, but if you want to stick around, I'll get it for you.
Perfect. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much for coming. We appreciate it, let's hope that we're back here again in another year or so, telling with the great results we've had from this program. If you have any questions, we'll hang around and answer any individual questions, but thank you very much.